Right there. It's an inspirational show. I must get this interview started, but first I have to take my new chunk first. Yes, my new chunk is a Montana Academy. Why you have it?
Neutral people, please say hi.
First, I have to take my NutriBird. It's the multivitamin.
Okay.
You know, it contains a lot of vitamins, vitamin B, vitamin B. Well, and what it does is your body absorbs what you need from all those vitamins, and what that it doesn't need it expels.
Okay.
And I find it to give me more energy like I need it.
Oh.
Like I need it.
Yes.
Like I really need it.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
It does. I try to give me more energy.
Yes.
Because it does that, I use it when I go to work at night. And I'll tell you something. Two nights ago, I went to work, and I woke up, and I was still feeling tired. And I said, okay, I got to get my vitamins. And in my hustle and my bustle, guess what?
What?
I forgot. So I didn't take my vitamins. Here it goes. There goes Facebook.
It's nasty.
It's not. It's really nasty.
I can't dummy vitamins.
Well, I need to drink the whole bottle.
I can let you have some.
Yeah,
you can tell me how it is.
Okay.
All right, don't take a whole cup now. Like, you know, maybe you a little bit half of it. Oh,
yeah. You put it in. Yeah.
That's that cup for me, baby girl. Get her some of this energy right here. And so let me tell you, I forgot to take my NutriBird. And let me tell you, I was tired the entire night. Because usually when I take it for the first 5 hours, I'm like, on the go.
Okay, okay.
And I felt the effects of it, so I know that it does. I don't know for some people.
I need it for tonight because I got to dance with the blast from the past.
For me, it does that to me. You're going to dance with the blast from the past?
Yeah, that's in Stanford. All right.
She's planning on party. Well, people, I've had my new show, Bird, go PLC. Yes. And I'm feeling good. And it's liquid, so it absorbs immediately and, you know, takes a fast. I'm feeling it. So, let's get on with my special. Drink some water. It's very concentrated. You want to try some?
No, I'm good.
You sure?
I'm good.
It's concentrated. It's more like a real rich orange juice.
Yeah,
flavor.
Yeah.
So you can add it to any kind of juice.
Right.
Or add it with water and
drink.
I take gummy vitamins. I don't do that.
Oh, well, this is
better than
gummy.
For people
with ADHD.
Yeah, oh, ADHD, that's me.
Yes. Well, I'm telling you, welcome to those that are listening, those that just joined in. I'm feeling kind of warm now.
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah, I think I'm coming.
Because the anointing
is going,
you girl.
Yes.
Praise the
Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Wow. Welcome to those that have just joined in. You're listening to the Real Love Inspirational Show right here on One Love Radio 106.5 in the Fearful Cash. Should have had your mic on all this time.
I know, right?
106.5 in the Fairfield County area and 106.3 in the Waterbury area. And you can listen online by going to djtresby.com. It'll take you right into the radio show, djtresby.com. Good morning, Daddy. My daddy's watching. That's djtresby.com. It'll take you right into the radio show. It's all for a chat room, and I'm not on the chat right now. Also, possibly currently on gospelreggaeam.com. Yes, you can welcome to those that are on gospelreggaeam.com. Those are my families over there. So good morning, and welcome to you, DJ Angel, Sergeant DJ Angel, all the way from Portland, Jamaica. Good morning to you. Yes, Carrie Bradshaw, OMG. Carrie Bradshaw is watching. He is a fabulous photographer.
Really?
Fantabulous. And
wow.
I'm proud to say he is Jamaican. Yes. So good morning to, let me this shout out to the Facebook watchers. Elaine, good morning to you. Kanisha, good morning. Rita, good morning. Lois, good morning to you. Carrie and Dee and Sharon, good morning to you. And for those that are watching that I cannot see, good morning to you. All right, so also you can listen on your phone for free. Just dial 832-225-5356. Number as three sequences. So I'll actually give it up three times. 832-225-5356. Once again, 832-225-5356. So if you're listening in your car and you're driving out of bounds, and you know, frequency, just dial that number, put it on speaker, and keep listening. All right, so let's get into my beautiful guest. This morning.
Yes, this is.
Yes. Can everybody just test the mic. Kim Kachu, Kaleem.
Hello.
All right, it's Cherie.
Hello.
All right, y'all sound beautiful. Don't sound beautiful this morning. So in the studio with me this morning, I don't know if you can see over here. Yeah.
Ah.
All right, let me adjust the camera so we can be in it for a minute. There. How about that? I think
you can put her in it.
Oh, sure. Yeah. She's always trying to hide from the camera. All right. So I think maybe you need to go to the corner right there and just turn the microphone. Okay. Don't fall off, baby.
Right.
I don't know about the insurance. Right? Don't do it. All right. I think that's a good spot for you. All right, good morning.
Okay.
Right. Let me see. I think I can see. I can say yo.
You can see me.
I say yo.
Not that
people. I can say yo.
I may talk to him, but I'm not.
Talk to people?
No,
yes,
no.
I do.
No.
Lord.
She's joking.
You never know.
You said it.
All right,
so let me introduce this beautiful young lady that is sitting right here. I don't know, maybe it should Cherie first.
Yes,
let's talk to Cherie Humphrey first. Yeah, because you act like you camera shy with your bling bling hat. I don't know what's on. You're beautiful. Don't buy from the camera. Please don't choke, all right? I don't feel like doing the Heimlich today.
You got your mittens in my mouth. You got to be careful.
All right. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. You're ready. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, so with me, my first person that will be speaking is with Cherie Humphrey, and she is the founder and producer and the CEO of Diamond and the Rough.
Yes.
Is it Finding the Star in Me?
Diamond and the Rough, Finding the Spirit in Me.
Oh, the Spirit,
yes.
Spirit in
yes,
me.
Yes.
All right. So tell us a little bit about that.
Okay. Well, Diamonds in the Rough, I will be celebrating 15 years of being in existence. The program came to me, you know, God was just working on my heart, and I knew I was dealing with a lot of issues at the time. I just got out of jail. I was living in a room at home. I was in between jobs. I was in recovery for alcoholism. And just going through a rough patch, God was just turning my life. You know, I just lost everything I owned after being in the master's program. I had a home, lost cars, everything. And I had to start over. And I was finding the Spirit in me because I got saved at 9, gave my life to Christ. But, you know, off and on as you're adolescent and young adult, you kind of stray away. And, you know, and I'm doing my own thing. So I thought. And so I always was telling people, you know, if I only had the support of parents, because my father died at 13 of, you know, dealing with drug use, and he had a kidney failure. And my mom, I didn't live with my mother. I lived in a group home. My great-grandmother raised me. So I didn't live with my mother very long. I went through a lot of abuse, sexual abuse and rape, starting from the age of 3. So at the time, you know, I said if I had the support, because I knew that God had put something in me, I knew that one day I would be on TV, I knew know how to express it.
Right.
So I got a calling from God in December of 2001. Started just flooding me with visions and visions and visions. And I stepped out on faith. I went and spoke to Shakita Stevenson about it. What do I do to start this program? What do I do? I spoke to my pastor, Reverend Perry, who supported me wholeheartedly and would give me the Bibles I needed to do the program at the Urban League. And I just learned by trial and error and by the Holy Spirit leading me. And we started off with doing curriculum at the Urban League Children's Village in New York City, the 21st Century Program, Country Day School, NBCC. Then I started doing a group called Talk to Me, because the kids, you know, they wouldn't open up, because some kids, when they're going through so much,
mm-hmm.
like I went through, they don't trust you.
Right.
And they gotta trust you in order to talk to you.
Right.
And so I kept saying when I was teaching, talk to me, talk to me, talk mm-hmm. to me. And so that's how Talk to Me began. I remember being at the Apollo and doing the Apollo, and my cousin came out to me, and he was like, look, Sheree, I want you to start writing. I'm starting Chocolate City News. So I said, okay, Alan, because everybody called him Rambo. I said, I'll start writing. I'll do a little something, but it got to be spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
It got to lift somebody up. It got to inspire somebody. That's the only way I'll do it. And so he was like, what's it going to be called? I said, it's going to be called Talk to Me. And that's how that got birthed. And you know, that opened up the door for media, the radio show, the column, everything else, because I wrote for a few different publications. Now with Stat Street, you can see Carolyn's article on there. She's a new winner for Star Is Born, our new Star Diamond for this year. So there was just a lot of, God was, you know, just working with me. Even though I was in my mess, He didn't look at that. Yeah, I was a total mess, you know, and he worked with my heart because he knew I wanted the word in me so bad, Rini, I would sleep with it under my head, you know.
So the word could get in your head when you sleep with it?
Yeah, so word can get in my head. That's how, you know, naive I was, but that's how much I wanted
it.
You know what I'm saying? And I would throw blessing oil in the tub with me because I wanted to be purified because I knew I was filthy.
You're trying to baptize yourself.
I'm trying to baptize myself. Even though I've been baptized 3 times.
Mm-hmm.
So the pastor's like, no, no more, Sheree. You already been baptized enough.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I heard you say that you were on the Apollo. When was this and what was this like?
Well, I was on the Apollo twice. First was in 2000. That was the month that I broke up after 18 years. Relationship, which almost half killed me, but that was the year I got on and I sang, but I was still in my mess. I was drinking, drugging. I yelled at Ray Chu and the crew through the microphone.
You yelled at Ray Chu and the crew?
Because I said, you ain't got the music right. And I slammed the mic on the floor. I mean, I was just off the rip.
The Sandman got you?
The Sandman came out and got me.
Mm-hmm.
But 2005, I did it again, and that's when I was doing spoken word, because I started spoken word in 2002, wrote my first book, published that in 2002, so I was doing a lot of spoken word. I was with Family Room Records in Brooklyn, and at that time, I was doing, you know, ministering, and I didn't even know that that's what I was doing.
Wow.
But I did the Apollo then. No, the Sandman didn't come get
Good,
me.
I'm surprised they let you back.
And started writing for my cousin Alan. Then I went to freelance for Harlem Magazine, writing for them, covering the McDonald's Gospel Fest every year, you know, because you was part of the team for Talk to Me, and you did a wonderful job. I told everybody you did a great job. I said, if it was, I could have went back to the hotel and just laid down and relaxed. I left y'all there.
that was an actual... awesome experience being at the Memorial Gospel Fest. I mean, the magnitude of people that was in that, what is that? I wouldn't even call it an auditorium.
It was a coliseum.
A coliseum.
The provincial.
20,000 20,000
people.
Yeah. Wow. And Yolanda Adams,
yeah.
Shirley Cecil,
Pamela
Mann.
Yeah.
She was awesome.
We all was crying. Remember?
Yes.
Tammy was crying. Trina was crying. I was crying.
Who
and
was crying? I was crying.
Oh, well, I don't know what she was doing, but all three of us was crying.
Why?
When she was singing This Place.
Oh, yeah.
Man, the anointing just fell on me, and I just was thinking about seeing what God is visualizing for my life, because in this journey, just because you're a Christian, it says many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Right.
You know, Moses had affliction.
Mm-hmm.
Noah had affliction. They thought he was insane. He had a drinking problem. Elijah had a depression problem. You know, but God used all of these people mightily. Joseph was in jail and locked up, but God was still using them in the prison. Paul, was shipwrecked, went through all types of hell. So did Job.
They all had a story.
They all went through something, but God still was using them mightily at that time.
But those are the people that God used.
Yes.
You know, because they came out of something that they can share with somebody.
Absolutely.
So, you know, we all have to go through the come forward with a testimony.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
We all have to go through.
That
was an awesome part.
Like, people don't know I'm about to be, I'm not claiming homelessness. I don't know where I'm going to live on by August 1st, you know. We still in the hole, 1875, from doing this event. So, and I'm not working, you know.
All right, you just said you're still in the hole from doing the event.
Yes.
You put on these events from your heart.
Yes.
From your heart and with the dependence of donations of
other people.
And there were some people that promised to donate to the cause.
Right.
And they stole through.
Right. Those were sponsorships that were giving more than, you know, just $100 or $200.
Right. For some reason.
And they didn't follow through like Charlie Coviello promised.
Don't call that.
Okay, I'm sorry. But, you know, you came on my radio show talking about I got good news and blah, 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 blah. I'm like, look, I'm about to shut
you
down.
You can call anyone. That's right. They're not coming after me. Call in.
You know, because this is these kids. When I got up there, Renee, and those babies were sitting on that stage and repeating the salvation prayer, Romans 10 and 9 through 11, that's when it hit me. Somebody up here is great.
Right. Because you went on without them.
Yes.
You know, with the holding on to faith.
Faith only. Faith. That unlocked the door because he wasn't going to let us in.
Right.
He was not going to let us in. And my pastor just prophesied to me, God is the only one going to do this, and God will unlock the door. And literally, he did. He did that day. That man would not, he said, look, I need $750 right now. And I had been praying for uncommon favor, and I just begged that man. And then the Holy Spirit just told me, don't say another word.
Mm-hmm.
Shut up.
Right.
And I sat right there. And next thing you know, that man was unlocking the door saying, I don't normally do this. He kept pacing. And I said, thank you, Lord, because I got people coming from out of state.
Right.
You know, I can't let them down.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
You know, sometimes we do these things. And people come and they have things to say about what you're doing and how you're doing it, but they don't know the story.
Yeah.
They don't know what you've been through, what you've gone through to get the doors open.
You know?
Absolutely. And I know that you're still seeking donations.
Yes.
Because you do have some debt that you do have to cover.
Yes.
Because you did this out of the goodness of your heart for these children.
Right.
Anything that has anything to do with children and keeping them out of trouble and having them shine for it. So if anyone is listening out there, find it in your heart to be a blessing to this ministry.
Yes.
How can they reach out and do that?
They can call me, 203-952-9807. They can go to our website, www.ditrfindingthespiritinme.org, or they can go to www.blogtalkradio.com/talk2CHERI, and all the PayPal information is up there, Square Cash. They can donate that way, or they can send it to my P.O. Box, which is Cherie Humphrey, P.O. Box 13,
Norwalk, Connecticut, 06852. And we're just trying to get the venue paid up immediately. And all the workers that came in there, you know, for the photographer, the videographer, et cetera, to get their balance.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. You have a phone number that they, you know, in case they don't remember all that stuff.
Okay.
They can call you.
Yeah, they can call me or text me, 203-952-9807. We've had over 20-something winners, first, second, and third. Since 2009, we've been honored by Congressman Himes, the U.S. Census Bureau. We've been honored by Hollaback Gospel Awards, Jerry Green at WYBC. We've been honored by SOB Awards that Lyle Don Jones gives for me turning my life around and reaching out to the community. This was our 21st event, 21st or 22nd event, since I've been in Bridgeport alone.
Yeah,
because I do Running Into the Light, which is for survivors of abuse, and Promises Fundraiser Awards Banquet, which commemorates how many years Diamonds and the Rough been in existence to raise funds and also to give awards and to recognize
people. Yeah, because you do recognize people that have been a blessing to you and the ministry.
Yes.
All right, so let's give that number out one more time for those that would like to be a blessing to Sheree and this ministry. And this is geared towards the young people. So if you find it in your heart, every dollar spent counts.
Absolutely.
All right, just like Aaron Vogt counts.
Yes. Aaron Vogt, you want to warm up?
Yes. So the number to call is 203-952-9807 to be a blessing to Sheree and her Diamond in the Rough.
Yes.
Finding the Spirit in Me Foundation. 203-952-9807. Once again, that number is 203-952-9807. And if you're listening, you can give her a call after the show. Hopefully someone will find it in their heart to be a blessing to this ministry. Also, you can find her on Facebook. She spell your name so they can find your Facebook.
Okay.
Maybe they can inbox you or something.
Okay. Well, I have two Facebooks. You can see Sheree Humphrey, Diamonds in the Rough, Finding the Spirit in Me. That's one Facebook. And my other one is Sheree L. Humphrey Producer. So I usually frequent the Sheree L. Humphrey Producer the most. But you can get me there on Twitter.
On Twitter, like
Instagram.
Go ahead.
Twitter, Instagram, Blogspot, the radio show, the column. If you put Sheree Humphrey in, that's C H E R I, you'll be able to find all of our links.
All right. So that's if you would like to be a blessing to Sheree Humphrey and this ministry, please reach out and do so. And later on, if you forget all that information, just reach out to me and I will pass it on. All right. Awesome. So, from this ministry that Sheree has created and nurtured out of nothing. Out of nothing, and continue to do it annually.
Yes.
You know, I pray God bless you that it will just continue to flourish and flourish.
Thank you.
You know, I will be starting my own talent show. It has nothing to do with you.
Yeah, okay.
Nothing to do with you.
Yeah, because we only do ages 8 to 21, but I try to include anybody that's outside of those ages to just come and be a feature. Because I don't like the little babies being in competition.
Right.
Because they start crying. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't understand.
Right.
So unless it's an exception, like the little boy who won last year.
What, he was
our, our Diamond Twinkles, the Mai Carter. He was exception to the rule. He was 7.5. And I let him in because he's bad. He's just real good. Yes.
From the last talent competition, and this one was
A Star Is Born 8, Watch and Wait.
A Star Is Born 8, Watch and Wait. Do you get a quote to match the number each time?
Yes. And sometimes God ministers to my heart. He'll drop something in my spirit. Be like, that's what you're going to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, me and, you know, Cherie Humphrey will say, this is what I'm going to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
But something to drop in my spirit, say, this is what you're going to talk about. So you need, you know, get in the Word and study this, what this means, and it was about waiting. You know, people, you know, thinking it's the delay of God, but God doesn't work in our timing.
Mm-hmm.
And just holding on and pressing in and
right.
watching and praying. So me and my ex came up with the title back in February because I didn't know what rhymed with eight. But I knew what I was going to be ministering from. I mean, you know, as far as the topic.
Yeah.
But he didn't give me the word. I came from Habakkuk. Habakkuk 3:2-4 was the main scripture.
Good morning, Devisha. You're present. Thank you for joining in. Good morning to you. All right. That was watch and wait.
Yes. Watch and wait.
All right. So right about now, I'm just going to just chill them the vibe a little bit and guide action. This, we will speak to this beautiful young lady that came out of Diamond.
Yes, my new baby.
The new diamond baby. Yes. We'll talk to her in just a minute. Right after this, you know, sometimes technology just takes so long to get going. All right. You feeling good over there?
know I love music. And every time I hear something hot, it makes me want to move. It makes me want to have fun. But it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here, it makes me want to...
Yeah.